guys. Thanks for watching the video today. We are going to change some strings. I've had several emails, and I've actually had some questions from some of my students that I teach here in Nashville, and they were, you know, they have a little bit of reservation about changing their own strings. So I wanted to do a simple video for them, kind of showing them a real specific way of doing it that I found throughout the years to work really well. Yeah, so we're going to go ahead and start up here. I'm just kind of rolling up a towel to put the guitar on to save the guitar from any scratches or anything, and save the tabletop a little bit too, I'm sure. But we're just going to go through a few things, kind of take you through the motions of changing the strings, and work you through a few of the techniques. Pack of strings here. I've got a... I think this is an old Planet Waves string winder. Any string winder will work. You don't really need one. This one has a string cutter on it. It also has this little groove right here that we'll use to pull out the bridge pins with. So it makes life a lot easier having one of these little string winders. I love it. I have several of them. You know, while we're at it here, I'm going to go ahead and, since this is sort of a beginner video, talk about some of the parts of the guitar here. This is the body. You know, so we're all speaking the same lingo. This is the body of the guitar. This is the neck of the guitar. Come down here to the bottom. This is going to be the bridge. Pick guard. We're going to back to the bridge here, but this is the bridge saddle, this little white piece. And then these little black pieces, which are hard to see, are the bridge pins, sometimes called the pegs. This is called the binding of the guitar. Some guitars have it, some guitars don't. These are inlays or fret markers here. These little dots, or these are kind of pseudo crosses here. What I'm trying to show you here, which is hard to see in the light, is the fact that the neck has what's called a fingerboard on it. You have the neck of the guitar, and then you have this thin piece of wood on the very top, and that's called the fingerboard. That's where your fingers are actually touching. Let's see here. On the far right, we have the neck meeting the nut, and I'm going to go ahead and unwind this string. Pull the string out of the nut here. And I'm just going to unwind it until I can unwind it by hand. Just pull it on through the tuning key. And we're going to take this string winder, take this little groove, and we're going to go back down to the bridge pin. Just pop it out. Sometimes you might have to pull a little harder than others. Sometimes if you've broken a string, your string, little piece of string will fall down the guitar. You might have to reach down there and grab it, shake it out, get an automotive magnet, it'll pull it out. We're going to go ahead and take the bridge pin here. Now, if you'll notice, the bridge pin has a groove cut in it. These bridge pins, once they've been kind of assigned a string, they like to stay with the string that they're with. So we're going to take that little groove and line it up with the string. Like I said, you know, the big string, keep each peg or each bridge pin with the string it came off of. Line it up, go ahead and push the bridge pin in tightly. Now I like to hold it and tug on the string. Now this is going to kind of pull it up to where it won't come loose. Just make sure it fits snugly. You don't want to press too hard on the top of your guitar because you can damage your guitar. But just press snugly, then we're going to come down here. Feed it through the tuning key. And, you know, I'm going to try to show you here the amount of slack you need to leave. I like to leave about a full finger's length on the low E string. So I'll kind of put my finger down there and I'll pull the string up to the where my finger meets my hand. And that's how much I keep. And you'll just kind of, each string is different and each guitar is different. Now here's the important part. We're going to wind this string. Now this tag end here is going to go underneath the string, and the string itself is going to go over the tag. So I like to say it's an over-under thing. It's over the tag, and then once we get to where the string's wrapped around, we're going to go underneath. And I'm trying to show you here with this angle. Just go underneath that. And now from here on out, every time the string wraps around, it's going to be going underneath the previous wrap. I'm just going to pull this kind of tight. It'll bend it out of the way. And then you can also just bend that downwards so you don't poke yourself in the eye. And the only reason I say that is because I've done it. I was seeing double for a couple of days and had to go to the hospital. So bend that string down and watch your eyeballs while you're changing your strings. You can hurt yourself. Go ahead and keep winding this string around. Again, we're going to keep every wrap under. I'm kind of repeating the video in different angles so that you can really get an idea. But first wrap is over, and all wraps after that go underneath each wrap before it. And what's going to happen is you're effectively pinning this string in there. You're locking it in. Got a little too tight there, and put it in the nut. And now I'm going to try to show you here with a different angle what this should look like when it's all said and done. Just cut this tag end off. Good to go. We've changed our string. Now, I didn't wrap this quite as far as I wanted to, but you can see how this tag end is now wedged in between two wraps of string. I like to have a few more than that. I'm trying to show several different, you know, kind of angles here on what exactly this should look like, but this is a good example of what each string should eventually look like when you're done. You have a top and a bottom portion that's kind of sandwiching in that little tag end of the string. Another comment that I seem to be getting is, when I'm trying to put my string in the guitar, I'm trying to wind the string up and change my strings, the string slips out right while I'm winding it, and I get all these creases in it. So here's an easy way to do it. Hold one end, pull on the other. And you'll see once there's a bend in that string, it's locked in. It's not going anywhere. So start your string that way and then start your wind. It's also good to remember to keep tension on the string with your right hand or your left hand, whatever hand's holding the string, while you're winding it. And that'll help help it wind correctly, and it'll also make sure that nothing slips. I set this towel up here a little higher so I can kind of work with the guitar a little bit better. Now, I've got the string in my right hand, and it is going over the top of the tag end. You can see how it's wound over the top of it there. Now, I'm going to pull up that tag and get that out of my way so I don't poke my eye, and keep winding. And now everything I do from here on out is going to go below the next. So I'm pushing down on the string with my right fingertip while I'm kind of keeping tension on the string. Now it's kind of got tight enough where I can wind it without having to keep a lot of tension on it. And there it is. We're going to clip off this tag end. There you go. We've changed another string. Now here what I'm trying to show you is two examples of what not to do, and then one example on what to do. The one in the middle, of course, is the right way to wind it. The one on the left, you'll notice that it's just wound. It's the string's been gone through, and then it goes under, everything goes underneath. The string on the right is kind of haphazard. The string in the middle is definitely something that looks like it's going to retain its tension, not slip out. Now we're kind of going to do just one string. I'm just going to change the string in one fell swoop so you can kind of see the motion. Sometimes it just helps to see someone do it. So lining up the bridge pin with the string, the little groove. Make sure we got the slack the way we want it. And this is sort of something you're just going to do over and over, and you're going to mess a few up, and sometimes you mess it up really bad, and sometimes you won't. But eventually you'll kind of get a hang for it, and you'll kind of know what it needs to be for each guitar you're doing. Now here we go. I'm going to go over the top of the tag, press down on the string, and now I'm going underneath, every wind underneath. I know I keep stressing that, but I just wanted to get it ingrained in your head. Of course, if you forget, just come back and watch the video again. Notice how my first finger is pushing down on the string while my ring finger is pulling up on the string. until the tension gets enough to where I can let go. Keeping that tension on the string as it goes around the tuning key will make sure it doesn't have a loose wrap, which can cause tuning problems. And there we go. Now we're going to stretch the string out. Pretty simple concept. Grab it and pull on it. Don't grab too hard. But, you know, definitely be firm. So that's nice if you have a table to sit at and you've got a place to do this. But sometimes you're at a gig or you're backstage, or sometimes you're just at your couch watching TV and you want to change your strings. This is sort of what I do. You see kind of what I'm doing here. Putting my feet down and I'm laying the guitar on my feet. Kind of wedging it in there. I apologize for not being able to see the headstock here. I kind of didn't realize that I was doing that while I was filming it, but you get the idea. I'm going to go ahead and remove the bridge pin. Wind these strings up here. Get the new fresh string. Grab the bridge pin and line up the groove. Put it in there and tug on the string. There's no right or wrong way to do this, but I've just seen a lot of videos on the interwebs. And there's a lot of people that are bored and want to show people how to do things. And I think it's awesome because there's so many things that I've learned by watching YouTube. But sometimes you learn things, you know, not in the most efficient way. I've been playing guitar a long time, and I've had plenty of chances to do it the wrong way, and I've had a lot of people kind of correct me over the years or show me a better way of doing things. I'm always up for learning something new from someone else, so this is just my way of passing that on to you. There we go. Voila. String change. We'll go ahead and stretch them out, and that's how to do it sitting up. I don't know, I just kind of felt like I would show this. There's, you know, I kind of take for granted the things you sort of learn over time. You know, if someone had showed me that, I probably would have done it a long time ago. So this is, I guess, my way of doing that. And there it is, guitar restrung. So here I just wanted to show, you know, what the headstock should look like when you're finished. On a guitar like this that has three tuning keys on the top and three on the bottom, you just want to make sure that each string goes from the inside out. You can see the top is all wound one direction, the bottom's all wound the other, and they all go from the inside out, and that's the way you want it to look. Guys, I hope this video helped you gain some confidence, and if you're new to the guitar and you've never changed your strings before, I hope this helps you. And maybe some of you guys who are veterans out there that have been playing a long time, you know, maybe you learned something new, a new way to wrap your strings to maybe help your Les Paul stay in tune. So, hope you enjoyed the video. Please like it if you did. Please comment. Feel free to question. I look forward to answering any questions you have. And until next time, go practice.